Good day, greeting students. I'm very happy to meet you all again in class 11 business studies. So we have completed one full chapter, what it is, nature and purpose of business. In that we have discussed various things about business. What is business, the definition of business, and then the concept, the characteristics of business, the differentiation between business, professional and employment, business risk, cause of business risk, and at last we discussed about how to start a business. When you are going to start a business, what are the basic factors that we have to take into account before starting your business, or when you are deciding about your business. Out of that, the first topic that we have discussed was selection of line of business, and then we decided about the size of business, and then finally the third point was choosing your form of ownership, choice of form of ownership. Now chapter number 2 is more related to the choice of form of ownership. The chapter 2 is going to deal with the various forms of business organization. So I'm very happy to start with chapter 2, which is going to be forms of business organization. So chapter 2 of class 11 is going to be forms of business organization. Now we know what is meant by business and all the further risks that we have to undergo if we are going to do a business, and what will be the objectives and everything we have discussed. Now what are we going to discuss? What is the form of business organization that we are going to start? Discussing about the business organization, why is it essential to choose my proper form of business organization? Because I need to know what kind of organization that I am going to run. There are various kinds. We are going to deal with 5 different forms of business organization. So out of that, we need to choose the best one. If you want to choose the best one out of some choices, you need to know the features of it. We need to know the merits and demerits of each choice that we have. The same is going to happen with chapter 2. What are we going to discuss here? We are going to discuss the features, merits and demerits of each form of business organization. And then finally, we are going to discuss the factors that influence the choice of form of ownership. Right, so once we have discussed individually about each form of business organization, we are going to have a comparison of which is the best, what is good in it, what is good in that form of business organization, which form of business organization is good for my line of business. All these things we are going to deal with in this chapter. So first let us start with the classification. What are the classifications of business organization? So now let us have a flow chart here. Business organizations are basically classified into 5 kinds, 5 forms. Okay? So the first one is called as sole proprietorship. Okay, the first one is called as sole proprietorship. The second one is called as Hindu undivided family business, or more popularly known as joint into family business. It's kind of a traditional method, a traditional form of business organization. And then popularly we know when we have a business organization, we discuss about partnership. Is it a partnership firm? Do you have many partners and all those things? So partnership. And then we have cooperative societies. We have cooperative societies. And finally, we have joint stock company. Joint stock company. What are the major classifications of business organization, children? We have sole proprietorship, joint Hindu family business, which is otherwise called Hindu undivided family business. Then we have partnership. Again, there are various classification in partnership. What are the various kinds of partners we have, and what are the various kinds of partnership also? So there are various kinds of partners: active partner, sleeping partner, dominant partner, nominal partner. We will discuss in detail when we deal with partnership. Again, there are various kinds of partnership: partnership by capital, partnership by liability. That also will be discussing. Then we come to cooperative societies where people invest. We get to have a chance in it. And then finally, we have joint stock company. Joint stock company is where we buy shares of a company and we join into that particular organization. So these are the various kinds of business organization, children. And what are we going to do in this chapter? We are going to deal with each and every form of business organization individually. That is, we are going to study about the features, merits and demerits, that are the limitations of each form of business organization. Why do we have to do that? Only then we'll be able to choose the right form of ownership that we can have for our own business organization. Right? So we are going to start with sole proprietorship, which is found to be the easiest form or the simplest form of business organization that we have. Now, sole proprietorship, why is it called the simplest form? Because sole proprietorship, the meaning of the word sole itself is single. The meaning of the word sole is single. Proprietor means the owner. So the single owner is going to be handled by only one person. So it is the simplest form. The features, merits and limitations are going to be discussed further in detail. And why do we call it simplest form? Because it does not have many legal formalities. It does not involve many people in it. When many people don't come, things become simple. That is why we call it simplest form of business organization. But still, it can be used for small scale organization. We cannot have big, large organizations or industries with sole proprietorship. The more favorable industries, not even industries, shops that we can have with sole proprietorships are, like you go to a stationery shop, that is a sole proprietorship business. You go to any petty shops, small shops, petty shops means small shops, are called as sole proprietorship, where you find only one owner for the shop. Stationery, then photocopy shops, not Xerox, photocopy shops, you know, computer centers, which is run by only one person. Basically, it is of small scale industry. Small scale shops, small scale business comes with sole proprietorship. It is more favorable when you are going to start. For the beginners who enter into business can start with a sole proprietorship, since it has many nice advantages. So we are going to deal in detail now with the advantages, limitations of sole proprietorship. But before we go into the advantages and limitations, we should know what are the features of sole proprietorship. So that is what we are going to deal first. Now, sole proprietorship, the person who runs that particular organization, he himself all alone is called as a sole proprietor or a sole trader in it. Okay, in case of trades, he is called a sole trader. How is sole trader or sole proprietorship defined? Sole trader is defined as a form of business organization where only one person, only one owner is responsible for the entire business. He alone takes the risk, he alone bears the risk. So he is the only recipient of the profit that comes out of the organization. Sole proprietorship or important thing in anga ore oruthanga da owner a irupanga, and the oruthar and the owner mattum da decision making la irupanga. He alone will bear the risk, and the company oda ella business risk. We discuss business risk detail. So whatever is a business risk, whatever is the degree of business risk, he alone is the only responsible person to bear the risk. And hence what happens? Profit is a reward of risk taking, right? So the entire profit that comes out of the sole proprietorship goes only to the sole proprietor. How do we call a person? Sole proprietor. The form of business organization is sole proprietorship. The person who runs the business is called as sole proprietor or sole trader. Why do we call it a sole proprietorship? Because only one owner is going to be there. One. So, talking about sole proprietorship. What is the meaning of soul? Soul means single. And proprietorship means ownership. Okay? So when you bring down, when you break down the word soul proprietorship, you get the meaning single ownership. What is the one more important term that we have to remember here? Proprietor. Proprietor means owner. The person who runs the business. So, the person who runs the sole proprietorship is called a sole proprietor. That means single owner of the business. So, what are the kinds of sole proprietorship business that we see? Sell a vegetable seller, grocer, green grocer. He alone will have a shop. He'll go buy in the market. He's actually a trader, sole trader. He buys lots of vegetables from the market. He brings it to the shop or he brings it to your home and sells it directly to you. He does not or she does not take into account anybody else. So he has to walk or he has to travel or he or she has to bring the products to you directly, and the risk is taken by that only one person. The profit also is earned by that person. We don't have any other person involved here. The main thing about sole proprietorship is only person is involved in all the activities of the business. Let it be managerial decisions, let it be planning, let it be purchasing, let it be selling, let it be marketing. Anything and everything is done by only one person, who is called the sole proprietor. Right, children? That is the meaning of sole proprietorship. Now we know what is sole proprietorship and we know what is sole trader. Sole trader is defined as a form of business organization where only one person, the owner, runs the business and he or she is responsible for taking the risk, for bearing the risk, and hence receives the entire profit of the organization. He or she does not have to share his or her profit with anybody else. That is the meaning of sole proprietorship. Now we move on to the next topic, which is going to be the features of sole proprietorship. What are the features of sole proprietorship? When we discuss about the sole proprietorship, how are the what are the important points or what are the important characteristics of sole proprietorship is what we are going to see now. So we'll start from here. Features of sole proprietorship. First characteristic is about the formation and closure. That is the start and end of the business organization. To start the business organization, the sole proprietor does not have to consult with anybody. He or she is the only person who is responsible for starting the business or forming the business organization. He or she does not have to take into account anybody else's decisions while forming the company. And closure, it is very easy to close the business organization also because he or she does not have to consult or ask anybody. If he or she finds that it is difficult to run the business, or if he or she finds that it is better to go for some other business line, it is okay. It is only the sole proprietor's idea to close the business also. So the formation and closure of the business organization lies entirely in the hands of the sole proprietor. He or she does not have to ask to anybody about the formation and closure of the business organization. The second point is the liability. Liability is kind of the debt, okay, to whom we are answerable or to whom we are payable is kind of liability. Liability lies entirely with the person who, the sole proprietor. Okay, the liability, the capital is invested only by the sole proprietor. So he or she is liable only to himself. Okay, for example, if there is a loss, he or she does not have to answer anybody. There is a loss of 80,000. The asset or the value of the business organization is 60,000. The 20,000 comes out from the pocket of the sole proprietor. He or she does not have to pay to anybody else but to pay himself. He or she is liable to himself. Namma vandu yaarukku answer panna vendam. Ipo for example, if we are in a partnership company, if I face a loss, it has to go for the other partners also. But here, profit or loss entirely relies only with the sole proprietor. It does not have to go with any other person. So liability eppadi irukku, it is mostly unlimited liability. Na nammaloada personal belongings adhula irukku. Sole proprietor thaniya avarkku oru vehicle, avaroda business organization ku thaniya oru vehicle vaanganum avasiyam illa. And the personoda personal vehicle-ஐயும் அவங்க business organization-க்கு யூஸ் பண்ணலாம். So it does not end with the business organization. அவரோட personal assets மேலேயும் there is a liability for the business organization. Okay, when we see the organization, it is an artificial person. It stays away from the owner. So the business organization can make use of the personal assets of the sole proprietor also. That is all about liability. So liability is mostly unlimited here. He or she has to undergo or invest his or her own personal savings also into the business in case of a loss. And then comes risk bearer and profit recipient. Who is going to be a risk bearer here and who is going to be profit recipient here? It's both going to be sole proprietor only. He or she has to bear the entire risk of the organization, and at the same time he or she has to or is allowed to enjoy the entire profit of the business, because there is nobody else in the company. He or she is the only owner of the business organization, and hence what happens, whatever risk it is, we have discussed about various business risk, types of business risk, causes of business risk and everything. And the person, the sole proprietor, is the only person who is liable to face the entire risk of the organization. Whether it is small or whether it is huge, the degree of risk may differ, but the person who bears the risk is only going to be the sole proprietor. And hence, the profit, whatever profit comes, is enjoyed only by the sole proprietor. So, who is the right person to enjoy the profit of the organization? Sole proprietor is the only person authoritative to enjoy the profit of the sole proprietorship. Hey children, talking about risk, I have asked you to look into the methods of handling risk, like insurance and all those things, how to avoid or how to prevent ourselves from the risk. I hope you have looked into it. If not, please look into it, because risk is something that we are going to discuss in all the forms of business organization, because we have seen already risk is inevitable. It is an essential part of business, and you can achieve profit only if you are ready to take a risk. That is why here even we say risk bearer and profit recipient in the same point, because profit is a reward for taking risk. It cannot come without one another. Hence, risk is an important factor in any business organization and in any form of business organization. The degree of risk may differ, but risk is essential. It is always there in the form of business organization. The next point is control. one of the important functions of management, that control, that is to set an objective and to go according to it. Whenever there is a mistake, we have to come back to our own path. So the control of the business organization, the profit, the loss, the investment, the dealings, everything is in the control of the sole proprietor. To whom I should sell, to whom I can distribute my product, to which shop, how I have to choose my transportation, everything lies within the hands of the sole proprietor. There is nobody else in the decision making process. So the entire control of the business organization lies with the only and only person who is called the sole proprietor, right? The next thing is no separate entity. Even though we say that business is an artificial person, company is an artificial person, it has to be seen away from the owner. When it comes to sole proprietorship, the business and the owner are the same. Right, it cannot exist without one another, because whatever decision the owner takes affects the business. Same way, whatever happens in the business affects the owner. So they are mostly one and the same. If the business closes, the sole proprietorship also closes. The sole proprietor also loses his business. If he or she dies because of some reason of death, then the sole proprietorship, the business entirely closes. So it depends entirely on the owner, and the owner depends on the sole proprietorship. So it cannot survive the one another. So we cannot call it a separate entity. Both are one and the same. That is, sole proprietorship and sole proprietor are one and the same. You cannot keep them away. Whatever decision taken by the owner affects the business, and same way, whatever happens in the business affects the owner. Right? So it cannot be seen without one another. And finally, lack of business continuation. So already we have discussed that we have only one owner. So something happens to the owner and the owner decides to close down the business, the business organization closes down. So something unexpectedly has happened to the owner means that is the end of the business organization. The business organization cannot run without the owner, because he is the owner and only owner. We have seen, right, there are some small shops near your home, some provision shops where you go, sometimes the shop is closed. Why do when we ask why is the shop closed, we'll get one answer that the shop owner is not feeling well, or he or she has gone out of station. So what happens? The business closes just because of some reasons of the owner's inabilities, right? Whether he might be out of station, or he is not feeling well, or some serious injuries, that means the business will get affected. The business cannot continue without the owner, because again and again we are talking about the one and only person who runs the business, who is called the sole proprietor. Hence, the sole proprietorship is defined with these characteristics. What are they? Formation and closure. There is an easy way of formation and closure in sole proprietorship, because it's going to be only one person. There are no much legal formalities for forming and closing of sole proprietorship like other business organizations. In other business organizations, refer பண்ணி பார்த்தோம்னா அங்க நிறைய rules இருக்கு, நிறைய laws இருக்கு, நிறைய regulations இருக்கு. But when it comes to sole proprietorship, we don't have that many legal environment that affects, legal rules that are imposed on sole proprietorship. So the formation and closure becomes very easy in case of sole proprietorship. Then comes liability. We discuss if the liability is unlimited, because he or she is the only owner of the organization, and hence if there is a loss, even the personal properties of the owner will have to be balancing the loss, and he or she uses his or her own his or her own personal properties for the use of business also. Even though there is not a separate transportation facility for the business, the personal property of the owner is used there. So liability is unlimited. And then comes risk bearer and profit recipient. Both are the same person, the sole proprietor. The sole proprietor has to take the entire risk of the organization, and hence the profit is received only by the owner. Since he or she is only risk bearer, the profit also goes only to the sole proprietor. Control. The control of the business organization lies only within the hands of the sole proprietor. He is the only person in the decision making. In any kinds of decision or any kinds of activities of the business, the right person or the only person to take decisions or any other steps is the sole proprietor. So the control lies in the hands of only one person, who is going to be the sole proprietor or the owner of the business. Then no separate entity. The business and the owner cannot be seen differently. They are one and the same. If the business ends, the owner also, what to say, he'll not become an owner after that, right? He'll become a normal person. Till the business runs, he is the owner of the business, he is the sole proprietor of the business. If the business is closed, then he is a normal person. He cannot be called a sole proprietor. And then lack of business continuation. Because there is only one owner in this organization, the business has to be closed if something happens to the person, and hence the business, the life of the business organization is very, very limited and uncertain. That is even a business risk. Clear? So far we have discussed about sole proprietorship, the various out of the five different forms of business organization. The first form of business organization is sole proprietorship. Here, what is the meaning of sole proprietorship? Single ownership. The person who runs the business is called as a single owner, that is the sole proprietor. What are the features of sole proprietorship? Formation and closure is going to be simple. Liability is unlimited. Risk bearer and profit recipient both are one and the same, the sole proprietor. Control is going to be in the hands of the sole proprietor. It is not a separate entity. The business cannot be seen without the owner, and the owner cannot exist without the business. And finally, the business cannot be continued if something happens to the owner. So the lack of business continuation is one of the features, even though it is one of the features of this form of business organization, it serves to be a limitation also. So what is the next topic that we are going to discuss? We are going to discuss about the merits and limitations of business organization, of this form of business organization. Now we came to know what is sole proprietorship and this. Only when we know what is the outcome of it, what would be the merits and what would be the demerits of this form of organization, we will be able to take a proper decision. Hence, we are going to see about the merits and limitations of sole proprietorship. Everything has both. Just like how a coin has two sides, positive, negative, everything, good, bad, everything has two ways, two sides. Same way only we have merits and demerits. So first we are going to discuss about the merits of sole proprietorship. The first merit of sole proprietorship is easy decision making. Because it impacts a lot on the business. It has a huge impact on the business. The right decisions. The right decisions will lead us to success, whereas any bad decisions will pull our legs down. So it is important that the decision making process should be right. Not only right, it should be quick. When a problem happens now, the decision should be taken very quickly, because it has to be, the problem has to be solved. It cannot be kept in cold water for a long time, and hence we need quick decision making. And here in sole proprietorship, the decision making serves to be an easy one and a quick one. Why? Because the answer is in the question itself. sole proprietorship means only one owner is going to be there, and that one owner is a responsible person to take any and every decision of the company, of the business organization. So it's very easy. When one person is going to think, he knows what are the problems, what are the resources, solutions. He can just weigh which is the best solution out of that, and he can easily and quickly make a decision. So the decision making serves to be very easy in sole proprietorship form of business organization. And then information that kept confidential. What do we mean by the term confidential? Confidential means secrecy. So when we say confidential, that it is kept in a secret way is what we mean about. Confidential information means the information of the organization is kept in a secret way. It is not exhibited or it is not told out to the other members. Why? Because there are no other members in the business organization. There is only one person who knows about decision making, who knows the profit and loss, the capital and everything. Is the only one person who we have already discussed, that he is the sole proprietor of the organization. So the confidentiality of information is high. Nobody will get to know what happens. This is very important. Why do you think that information should not be shared with some others? So we have heard news, or we have seen in movies, that when we are quoting an amount for taking a tender or taking a contract, the information somehow passes to our competitors, where they might quote huge amount or less amount, and they may take the order instead of us. So information, business information, are very, very important. Not that only huge information will affect us, even tiny little information, our business policies, our plans, everything is most inevitable for any organization. So sole proprietorship gives you the ability or gives you the right to keep your information in a confidential way. That is, you don't have to share it with anybody else. That's why main merit of sole proprietorship is confidential information. That is, the information does not go out of the business organization, because the only one person runs the organization. So he or she can pass the information to only the people who he or she wants to know the information. The information stays safe, so the company also stays safe. And then comes direct incentive. Here the incentive is going to be profit. Right. The incentive means what? Some kind of a reward, a remuneration. That is going to be the incentive for us. So direct incentive, there are not going to be any middleman who is going to take your profit. Unlike in employment, if you see, there is a profit, but employees are paid only salaries. Even in business it happens, right? When you have a partnership business or joint stock company, the entire profit is not enjoyed. It has to come in steps. It has to be taken in percentages. Whereas in sole proprietorship, as you are the only owner of the business organization, the incentive comes directly to your hands. For example, take peddlers and hawkers, people who sell small scale things to your home. They come to your home and they sell. All vendors. We'll buy, for example, we'll take a greengrocer who has bought vegetables for that particular day in the market for 200 rupees. He or she takes it to various areas and sells it for 250 rupees. So the profit is going to be 50 rupees. And from where he or she is going to get it? Not from anybody else. He himself is going to directly realize the profit that comes out of it. So the sole proprietor enjoys the merit of direct incentive. He or she does not have to get it from someone else, but can enjoy it directly by himself or herself. Then comes sense of accomplishment. This is very important, not only in business organization, as far as we are concerned, as far as every individual is concerned, sense of accomplishment is very, very important. What is it basically? Satisfaction level. Your self satisfaction level. For example, when you see an LKG child takes his notebook or her notebook and draws a picture, colors it. After some time, what happens? He or she takes the picture and looks into it, admires his or her own work, how he has colored, how she has colored, what are the things that has to be. An LKG child will not think that much, but at least will admire, will try to change the colors, will try to make the improvements. That is self-satisfaction. Only when the child gets satisfied of the work, he or she, the child, will show it to the parents, to the teachers, and to everybody else. Take for instance, students like you. When you make an assignment, when you do an assignment, after you finish, you go through it. You check whether you have attended all the questions, whether the presentation is neat, whether you have underlined the things, and all these things. Only when you are satisfied, you pass it to the teacher, you submit it. Take for instance your mothers. When they cook something, they taste it first. They taste it, they make the necessary arrangements or adjustments, whatever has to be done. And then when they are satisfied that it is tasty, they give it to you. It travels. This sense of self-satisfaction is where we have the sense of accomplishment, that we have done something very well. So this sole proprietorship leads you to have the sense of accomplishment, because you quickly will know what is your incentive. You quickly will know how your business organization is doing, because you're directly related into it. So you will get to know the clear picture of your business. So the sense of accomplishment is high. How well I have conducted my business, how well I have marketed my product, how well I produce my product. When you are running a restaurant, a small scale level restaurant, when people come and say that the food is very tasty, you will feel very happy. It is because the sense of accomplishment, you get the comments directly. Since you are directly involved, you get this sense of accomplishment, which is so good. When there is a correction, when there is a criticism also, you can easily take it into account and do the necessary corrections immediately. So you get that sense of accomplishment only in which form of business organization? Sole proprietorship. There only you get the sense of accomplishment. Then the next merit is ease of formation and closure. So we have discussed it in the feature of sole proprietorship, that there are no legal formalities. Even there are some very few, innumerable, very few legal formalities which are not so difficult. Okay, if you're going to open a shop, you have to take the license for the shop, and very simple things. There are not much legal rules and regulations or restrictions like other organizations, like other business organizations. So the formation becomes very, very easy. If you have the enough capital, if you have the idea of running your business in a proper way, immediately you can start your business. And closure also becomes easy. When you feel that your business has to go in a different way, this is not your cup of tea, you have to face a huge loss, or when you want to do something else differently, you can immediately close your business organization. Again, there is no much of decision making here, no much of legal restrictions here for the closure of the business. So the formation and the closure of business becomes very, very easy. So what are the merits of sole proprietorship? Easy decision making, because the only decision maker. Then confidential information. Information will not go out anywhere. The meaning of confidential means maintaining the secrecy. Then direct incentive. You get the direct incentive, so you know what is happening in the business. You get good sense of accomplishment of what you are doing, whether it is good or not. You can easily analyze it. And finally, the formation and closure of business is very, very easy. Merits. Are there only merits in sole proprietorship? No. There are few limitations also. That is, limitations means demerits. Demerits in the sense, you need to know it just in case to avoid it or try to prevent yourself in it. If you are going to be a sole proprietor, you should know what comes out of it. That is the reason we are going to discuss about the limitations of sole proprietorship. What might be the limitations of sole proprietorship? Only one owner. No other interventions. Nobody is going to interfere in your business. Even then, are there going to be any limitations? Yes, there are going to be certain limitations, which are as follows. The limitations of sole proprietorship. First one is limited resources. The resources that you have to invest for your company is going to be limited, because first thing is capital, right? Money. We'll start with money. The resources are limited because only you are the owner, and hence you are the only person who has to invest the entire capital. Banks and other financial institutions will not come forward to lend you money as they come forward for big business organizations, because we have discussed already, sole proprietor means single person, and the small scale businesses only will choose sole proprietorship. So in that case, the banks will have a doubt of taking back their amount, that is receiving their loans back. Hence, the banks and financial institutions will think a lot for lending money for sole proprietors. Hence, the limited resources, financial resources are very limited. Whatever I have in my hand, if I have only 2 lakhs, I can start the business only with 2 lakhs. Okay, but in case of other business organizations, you may have the opportunity of getting the resources from somebody else, whereas here the resources are limited. Not only the financial resources, the physical resources also will be very less, because I have only 2 lakh. With that 2 lakh, I have to buy my raw materials, I have to start my production, whatever it is. So I cannot buy something for the transportation. Something or the other will be missing. You cannot buy everything with the limited capital that you have. So the resources overall, financial, physical, and all the other resources, human resources again, will be very, very limited, because you cannot have so many employees with yourself. Right, so if you see a tailor shop, tailors, they are also sole proprietors. They only start with only one tailoring machine, only one sewing machine. So their resources will be very less. They will have only one machine in the beginning. Okay, and then if they have to expand their business, that is if they want to have buy one more sewing machine, they should have first enough profit. Only with the profit or with the personal money, they have to buy one more thing. So the business may not help you out. Okay, and then they have to recruit one more person. So for not only for the installation of business, even for the expansion of business, we need resources. But in sole proprietorship, the resources are limited in nature. Next point is, resources may be limited, but the liability is going to be unlimited. What about the liability? As we have discussed earlier, it is going to be unlimited, because even out of my personal money, I have to take up and give money. If my sewing machine, if I am a tailor and I have started a sole proprietorship, if my sewing machine has got something wrong, I have to repair it. Means what I have to do? I have to give money from my pocket to repair it, to make it right. What happens? The liability is unlimited. Even from my own personal money, I have to give. Not only from the business or the capital or the profit that I have, even from my own personal savings, I have to give something for the business. So the liability becomes unlimited. From the installation to the expansion, even when you are closing your business, the liability is unlimited. If you are closing your business on a loss, then what happens? The remaining loss also, even the asset for 1 lakh you have faced your loss. 70,000 rupees assets you have, the asset of business is only 70,000. The remaining 30,000, if you have to pay the money to someone else, then you have to give your own personal assets also. So the liability becomes unlimited, because the only one person is running the business. Then, limited life of business organization. We have discussed throughout the session that there is only one owner, and only that one owner is responsible for the entire business. So if something happens to he or she, the business has to close down. You may not always think the family members will undergo or continue the same business. Right, they might be in different professions or they might be in a different business. So, if the person wants to close the business closes, something happens to the business, gone. Right, the business organization entirely closes. The life of business is very, very limited. If a person starts a shop, opens a shop in while he is 25 years old, he runs a business, he expands the business, but he is always a sole proprietor. He did not change his form of business organization, he is running as a sole proprietor. Someone in his family gets to transfer, so the entire family should shift. What happens to the sole proprietorship business? It also closes because a person should transfer with the family. So the life of business organization is also very, very limited. And finally, limited managerial skills. We have discussed that various functions are there in management and in business. You need to plan, you need to buy, you need to sell, you need to market your product, you need to research about your product, you need to develop your product. There are so many things. But we have only one person here. And can we say that that one person will have all the managerial skills? Whether he will be a good person to plan, a good organizer, a good director, cannot happen all the time. One person cannot be good in everything. Right? One or the other will lack. When one or the other lacks, this whole proprietorship business also get affected. That is the reason that we say limited managerial skills are going to be a very difficult thing for the business organization. But no other way in sole proprietorship, because he or she is the only owner, they have to take their managerial decisions they themselves. And hence they need lots of skills. But what happens? A person cannot be good in everything. Right? Okay, I started my business. Suddenly I want to expand my business. So I want to know about the legal validities of the expansion of the business. If I want to open a branch in a different place, can I do it? Then it cannot be a sole proprietorship because I have to appoint someone or I have to rely on someone. So what happens? Your business has to remain in only one place. Happens. Then when you want to take a decision, you will not be having any other people to help you out. You are the only person. That is even one important demerit here, because one person cannot be good in everything. So the limited managerial skills will definitely affect your business. So what are the demerits of the business organization? That is sole proprietorship. Demerits or limitations of sole proprietorship. Limited resources. The resources are limited. Let it be financial or physical, the resources are limited. Unlimited liability. Resources may be limited, but the liability is unlimited. Limited life of business. As the owner ends his life, the life of business also gets over. So the life of business is very, very limited because of various reasons. And managerial skills are limited. It affects the business in expansion or in the development of the business. So today we have discussed about the various forms of business organization, that is the classification. And in detail, we have studied about sole proprietorship, the features, merits and limitations of sole proprietorship. I want you all to kindly go through the topic and make sure you have understood all the topics. Thank you and may all have a good day to each other.